no less, amidst the scream. Hey, stop squeezing, Lee. No space on my train already. Indeed, I must admit I'm part of the national calamity, a part of the talentless office crowd, with no talent to even get onto the crowded train to work. But what is talent? If I were talented, I'll say that talent is something that you see in yourself and fail to see in others, and your attempts to hide this weakness go to the great length to proclaim the calamity that a drop will be the end of your existence. It is the privilege of the few with the bargaining power of the maker to be born in the correct families to fathers and mothers who in their own right are signatures of the talented. It is not about who you are or what you do, it's about what you get, and when you have it, you just keep going up and up and up until you forget the world that you came from, until you feel like you're a god. For the talentless me, I should be contented at the tiny spot that I'm given. But I plead quietly at this foreign but obvious talent to move further into the emptier space, for I'm even unworthy to smell its armpit, not to mention that it's stuffed in my face. Talent has its own idiosyncrasy, I reckon. Not something that a Singaporean Chinese who, according to Cheryl on Facebook, cannot hold an intellectual conversation, who reads trash from the iPhone, can understand. Talent is white, talent is black, talent is foreign. Talent is anything that I can think of, but cannot. Finally, as the train pulled at my stop, talent was standing in between me and the door. So I said, excuse me. They said, what? I said, excuse me. They said, what? I said, excuse me. And they said, what? Yeah, such is the conversation between the talented and the talentless. And in that moment, the train left.